Hello guys, this moment is a moment that I've been waiting for with a lot of patience, and now it's finally here. It's time to place the cannons, the side cannons for starters, and then the cannons on the deck. But the cannons on the deck needs to be tied on, and we have to place some rings and stuff. But before doing that, I'm going to place the side cannons, these ones. I believe the result will be breathtaking. So, I'm ready to begin. And when I place them, I will show you the ship with the cannons on, with the funnels dried, to see it, at this stage at least, in all its glory. Also, when I finished placing the cannons on the deck, the side, or, the lamps at the stern, and a few little other stuff just before proceeding to the dead eyes, I will make a 4K video just to see how the ship looks until that step. So, let's begin in placing the cannons. If you remember, I have opened up all the holes right here. Later on, I will reopen the holes from the vanish at the platforms here, also at the deck. That's later on. But now, I'm going to place the cannons. Now, it's easy. Doesn't need requires too much skill, just some glue around the hole and insert it, but you have to hold the ship so you can insert it at its place. Easy enough. Nothing hard, nothing too difficult. Just be careful to check the hole that it's open before you insert any cannon, because right here I'm seeing a hole that is not opened. This one is tough. Okay, let's move to another one. Let's change the cannon. Harder than I thought, but definitely I will get what I want. This one was easy. Now you get the idea. Maybe some holes need to be reopened. Maybe you need to use a small hammer with not much pressure to not destroy the cannons or the paint. And so let me place over 100 cannons and I'll get back to you to show you the result. And it's done. It's spectacular. It's absolutely beautiful. And I'm missing the deck cannons. Look at these lines. Beautiful, very beautiful. Now guys, before I place the cannons, I believe I must place the ladders. There are three of them and goes right here. So let me prepare myself, get the materials I need, and I'll get back to you and we'll make it together. So guys, I'm going to make this. I have all the materials I need. I have this for the peripheral. This is the peripheral part of the lamp. These are for the base, or for the base, for the top. These are for the base, and this is the axle I need. Of course, I'm going to use my Dremel to make everything to be smooth and even. And also, I have these parts here for the center red color, and these are going to be cut according to this. Easy, I don't believe it's hard. So let's start by making all the edges disappear. Now, I have to cut three pieces at the 13 millimeter, so let me do that. I'm going to mark it a little bit bigger. I'm going to mark it at 15 because I have to, as you saw right here, to make it straight. Now guys, it's time to cut the inside of the ladders, of the lamps, if you wish. Now guys, I believe we have more than enough. I have to cut three, so I believe the size of the patterns here gives me the possibility of a mistake. Also, I have to tell you that what I'm going to cut here must be a little bit smaller. This is one, because it has to fit inside. This is two. And this is three. So, let me get my scissors to cut them off and I'll get back to you. Now guys, let's try to make one together and see if I got this right. Let's make one of the small ones. Now this is the base. This must go around the base, and this is the cover, so again this must go around the cover. Before doing anything on that, we have to bend it. As you can see, it has some cuts, so it's easy to do that, just a little at a time. And we will repeat the process until we get a circle. Again. Make sure that the circle is tighter, so it will be able to glue on. And these are matched, like this. Now, first the bottom. Let's glue. Let me place some glue here. Now, before placing the cap, which is this one, we must place this. Let's make it round.
As you can see, it exceeds the top, so I must cut it off. Let's try it. It's beautiful. Some glue on the base to hold it there. And glue on the top so we can place the cover. And also, this is the final touch. And we have one lamp. Same procedure for the rest two of them. So, let me make them and I'll get back to you with the placement on the stem. Now guys, it's time to do the placement. The lamps are ready. And as I can see here, the two side lamps, the left and right, are goes exactly at the middle of the curved section. That's right here and right here. And the one that's left goes dead center. So let me do some measurement and I'll get back to you with the placement. Now guys, I have made three marks, one here and one here. Don't know if you can see them in camera. I'm going to use a hand drill and a drill tip at 1.5 millimeters. If I need more, I will reopen the holes with 2 millimeters. Now, this needs to be, I need to be extremely careful not to make any damage. So, let me adjust the camera so you'll be able to see. I need 2 millimeters. Let me check if they are aligned and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And guys, ready. They are in place, also varnished, and they look amazing. Let's have a look at the back. Beautiful. It's just beautiful. So the next step is to place the cannons on the deck. So until then, thank you very much for watching. See you soon with that beautiful next step.